الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صفيه وخليله أرسله بالحق بشيرًا ونذيرًا وداعيًا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجًا منيرًا. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، إن الله تعالى يقول في كتابه العزيز: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. ويقول سبحانه وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. My dear brothers and sisters, I selected for you, I chose for you today a hadith, a beautiful hadith. It's a hadith Qudusi narrated by Imam Abu Dharr al-Ghifari. He said he heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reporting that Allah said in this hadith: Ya ibadi, inni harramtu al-dhulma ala nafsi وجعلته بينكم محرما فلا تظالموا. يا عبادي، إني حرمت الظلم على نفسي وجعلته بينكم محرما فلا تظالموا. يا عبادي، كلكم ضال إلا من هديته فاستهدوني أهدكم. يا عبادي، كلكم جائع إلا من أطعمته فاستطعموني أطعمكم. يا عبادي، كلكم عار إلا من كسوته فاستكسوني أكسكم. This is the first part of the hadith, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, says, O my servants, I have forbidden oppression for myself and made it forbidden amongst you. So do not oppress one another. O my servants, all of you are hungry, except for those. O my servants, all of you are misguided, except those I have guided. So seek guidance from me and I guide you. O my servants, all of you are hungry except for those I have fed. So seek food of me and I'll feed you. O my servants, all of you are naked except those whom I clothed. So seek clothing from me and I'll clothe you. My dear brothers and sisters, Allah the Almighty subhanahu, one of his names is Al-Adl. He is Ar-Rahman, he is Ar-Rahim, the merciful, the most kind. He is the most just. Justice is the opposite of zulm, of oppression, of aggression, of injustice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I have made oppression forbidden for myself, so do not oppress one another. That's what Allah expects from His servants, that they live side by side, they treat each other well. By Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wisdom, we are all interdependent. We all need each other in this world. No one can do everything for himself. No community has everything. As individuals, we need each other. As communities, we need to deal with each other. And if we deal in a mutual and in a nice and friendly way, everyone benefits. If you respect others, and if you treat them like you treat yourself, if you like for them what you like for yourself, you are certainly a good believer. And you will not be among those who practice oppression against others. Because that you do not like it for yourself, you do not like it to be oppressed, so do not practice it against others. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade dhulm among us. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اتقوا دعوة المظلوم فإنه ليس بينه وبين الله حجاب. Beware of the dua of the oppressed, because Allah the Almighty hears their dua immediately. Their prayer is heard and answered. And those who practice oppression, the Almighty, the Most Just, He will make them pay for their injustice, for that wrongdoing they've committed against their fellow human being. Muslims, it is forbidden among them, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Muslimu aqul Muslim, la yadhlimu, wa la yaslimu, wa la yakhdhulu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described believers as brothers. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةً. Brothers are not meant to oppress one another. Brothers, by definition, they are meant to care for each other, to care about one another, to be, when you are in need, you'll find your brother there for you. And he will help you. He will not let you down. لَنْ يَخْذُلَكْ. And he will not give up on you. He will still care about you. وَلَا يَسْلِمُ. And he will not oppress you. This is the meaning of the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A Muslim is a brother of a Muslim. So by definition, we are all brothers and sisters. By the definition of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by the hadith, and by the ayah in the Quran al-Kareem, we are all brothers and sisters in the faith. And the rest of the people of humanity, they are also human beings towards whom we have a responsibility, and we care about them because we want them to hear the message of Islam. And we have, no one would listen to you if you mistreat them, if you oppress them, people will not listen to you. But if you're kind, if you are easy to approach, then people may listen. And if you practice the values in your life, you set a practical example, not somebody who's good with arguments, but in his real life, everything he says contradicts his behavior, his dealings with people, the way he deals with his business with people, contradicts his faith. People do not. People, they see, they listen, as some said, with their eyes. They see your actions. And if they are touched, they're touched by your behavior. So my brothers and sisters, no matter, you should not forget that you are a Muslim who has a responsibility towards the world, even if it seems all the world is against us. We have to unite our effort, we have to care about each other, we have to be there at the need of our brothers and sisters, but at the same time we should never lose sight of our responsibility. We have a mission, we have a responsibility to let the world know about the message of Islam. We should not let our anger or being upset of what's happening to us ever to lose our ways or our focus and our priorities. We are da'is, we are people who do da'wah, who call people. Sometimes, unfortunately, in the midst of working and earning a living, some of us, they think life is all about earning that bread, making ends meet. And they forget that Allah is the provider. And you will see in this hadith later. Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, that, يَا عِبَادِي كُلُّكُمْ ضَالٌ إِلَّا مِنْ هَدِيدٌ. Everyone who seeks guidance other than in the path that Allah chose to His people, other than Islam, if you seek guidance elsewhere other than from Allah, you will be misguided. So we are otherwise misguided unless we follow and we seek guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you are not a servant to Allah, you are a servant to shaitan. There is no other way. إِن لَمْ تَكُنْ عَبْدًا لِلَّهِ فَإِنَّكَ عَبْدٌ لِلشَّيْطَانِ فَأَنْتَ عَبْدٌ لِنَفْسِكَ فَأَنْتَ عَبْدٌ لِلدِّينَارِ. You are a servant of the dinar. You are a servant of your desires. You are a servant of shaitan. To be free and to be a dignified human being is to be only servant, a submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يا عبادي كلكم ضالون إلا من هديتم فاستهدوني أهديكم. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala went on to say, my servants, all of you are hungry except those I have fed. So my brothers and sisters, do not take your next meal on the table for granted. Always thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today you had beautiful breakfast. Whatever it is, think that there are those who do not have the same thing that you had. Don't ever look, I could have had that and that, but that's all I can afford. Thank Allah you can afford something. You have put something in your stomach. There are those somewhere people who are desperate for something, maybe days passes without eating a decent meal. Thank Allah for what you have. Be grateful to Him. Be grateful that He gave you the strength, the ability to wake up and to go and do your job, and you come back with an earning. Be grateful to Allah, and Allah will bless you in your income, bless you in your health, bless you in your family. So next time you go to eat a meal with friends or at home, think that this is a gift from Allah. Allah has helped you. The other part of the hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا عِبَادِي كُلُّكُمْ عَارٍ إِلَّا مَنْ كَسَوْتُمْ. All of you are otherwise naked, except those whom I have clothed. So the clothing you have on you, it's a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be grateful for what Allah gave you. Be humble. Don't let that piece of cloth on your shoulder makes you feel you are better than other human beings. Rather, be grateful and be humble and be modest. And be kind to those poor who cannot afford to wear the same standard or same style of clothes you wear. Thank Allah for it. Be a servant of Allah. When you go and shop for clothes, thank Allah that He gave you that. And when your old clothes become old, don't throw them in the bin. find a way. There are people who will be very happy to have your second-hand clothes, the clothes that you no longer need. And again, be humble and modest when you shop. Don't be wasteful. Don't buy every time you go, you have a jacket. You have more clothes than you can wear in a year. Why? Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be grateful to Him and be humble and modest in your expenditure. And don't be a fashion slave. You're only a slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't ever put a cloth on your shoulder so that you boast among your mates and among the people. Everything you put on your shoulder, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you have what others don't have. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفركم الله غفور رحيم. دان الله سبحانه وتعالى الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه والاه. Then subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this hadith narrated by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ya ibadi, innakum tukhti'oon bil-layli wal-nahar, wa ana aghfiru al-dhunuba jami'a, fastaghfiruni aghfir lakum. He said, my servants, O my servants, you commit sins day and night. You are sinners. We commit sins. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and Allah forgives all sins. So seek forgiveness from me, and I will forgive your sins. If a servant comes with equivalent amount of Uhud, all sins, but he returns to Allah in sincere repentance, Allah will bring towards him a mountain of forgiveness. Nothing pleases Allah more than to see His servant returning to Him in forgiveness. Make part of your daily dhikr al-istighfar. Astaghfirullah al-azim. Astaghfirullah. Always ask Allah for forgiveness. There are those little sins that you do them or say them without you paying attention to them. But they are serious. And so always be asking Allah to forgive you. Be always humble yourself to Allah and admit you do not have to confess to anyone, but Allah knows already, and you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive your sins. Allah is the most forgiving and merciful, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah went on to say in the hadith, يا عبادي إنكم لن تبلغوا ضري فتضروني ولن تبلغوا نفعي فتنفعوني. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not need our ibadah. The ibadah is for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not benefit in any way from us being good people, nor can we harm Allah in being the most wicked person. It does not affect Allah in any way. And this is exactly what has been elaborated further in the hadith. He said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم كانوا على أتقى قلب رجل واحد منكم ما زاد ذلك في ملك شيئا. If the first of you and the last of you, the human of you and the jinn of you, to be as pious as the most pious amongst you. To be as the most pious heart of any one man of you, that would not increase my kingdom in anything. Likewise, if then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O my servant, were the first of you and the last of you. If inna awwalakum wa akhirakum wa insakum wa jinnakum كانوا على أفجر رجل على أفجر قلب رجل منكم ما نقص ذلك من ملك شيئا. If the first among you and the last among you, the ins and the jinn, they were on the most wicked heart among you, it will not decrease my kingdom in anything. So we are not, we will not be able to add anything to Allah's kingdom, nor can we take anything from it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the hadith, لو أن أولكم وإنسكم وجنكم قاموا على صعيد واحد فسألوني فأعطيت كل واحد مسألته ما نقص ذلك مما عندي إلا كما ينقص المخيط إذا أدخل البحر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O my servant, were the first of you and the last of you, the human of you and the jinn of you, stand in one place and everyone makes his request. Request something from Allah, and Allah would give everyone what he requested. That would not decrease anything from what Allah, from Allah's kingdom or from what Allah has. Just like the needle, like the example of a needle. If you put it in the ocean and you take it out, what does the needle reduce from the sea? Nothing. That's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's power and kingdom. He is the richest, he is the most generous, and nothing pleases him than his servant return to him and ask for his matter, whatever it is, small or big. Dua is prayer, dua is ibadah. So please, before you ask other human beings, make your request to the Almighty Subhanahu, the most able, the one who hear you, the one who does not need wasta. You plead to him, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most generous. If he does not give it to you immediately, it means it has been postponed to a better time. If it's not in this dunya, Allah will have saved it for you on al-akhirah, where it really matters. But every dua is answered. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِ عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. If my servant asks you about me, then tell them I am close to them. فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. Allah is close. You do not need to travel by plane or by car. You do not need wasta. You do not need to spend any money. Wherever you are, make your request, make your dua to the one who answers to his servants for whatever they require from him, little or small. We want our boys and girls to practice dua. Teach your children to pray to Allah. Teach your children to link up with their Creator. And let them see that in you whenever you sit on the table to eat. You say Bismillah, and you say Allahumma barik lana fima razaqtana, and then you thank Allah for what He gave you. And when you are in need, you say, Oh Allah, forgive me, forgive my parents, Oh Allah, guide my children, Oh Allah, help me. It does not reduce anything from you, from your manhood. It does not reduce anything, rather it makes you higher and dignified. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves his servant who turns to him and prays to him. Because you are practicing the tawheed. Tawheed in action is when you exercise it in the time of need. You know to whom to return. And if anything does not happen the way you wanted it, then you submit to the will of Allah without losing your balance or losing faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ever don't question Allah. Question yourself. The wrong is within us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not wrong his servants. If something that you really wanted, you thought this is it, but it didn't happen. Allah, you should know that Allah maybe has prepared for you something better. If a door is closed by human beings, Allah will open more doors, 10 doors to you. Don't ever think that if you lose your job, your current job, it's the end of your life. Never! Allah will give you a better job. Allah will make, if you lost in a business deal, Allah will give you a better deal. But always link up with Allah. Don't ever let that line between you and Allah broken by observing your daily prayers and making your prayer real, not physical, not only exercises. I see some people do their prayer, before you know it is so quick. Wallahi, I pray behind some imams, yani even the Fatiha, you are reading it in a normal speed, before you finish it, the imam has already made. Nish! This is a moment! My God, 10 minutes too much in your prayer? How many times we spend watching nonsensical series and movies? What does it add to our life? Why are we doing something that has no usefulness to us? We don't look at the time. But when you are in a mosque, oh, the imam is taking long. Oh, the khutbah. Oh, the salat, the imam prays, we use long ayat. But when you stand and watch the movie after a movie, oh, it's okay. Brothers, question yourself. Dedicate the best of your time, the best of you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And wallahi, Allah will open the world to you. Allah is the one who has the keys to everything. Your wasta is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Help comes through human beings. True, but it is Allah had permitted it. Allah had sent it to you. So always thank the first, the Almighty, who sent that human being to help you. And whoever helps his brother had helped himself. You have to know that. You are supposed to be in the help and at the need of your brothers and sisters. I'll stop here, the hadith is long, but inshallah, maybe another khutbah will do the other part. Allahumma adina fi man hadayt, wa'afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallana.